In this video, we're going to explore the three parts to your soil biology, and that's microbes, organisms, and the plant roots that are in that topsoil. One of the things about plants in the wet tropics, whether it be sugarcane, tropical fruits, bananas, heliconias, vanilla, or pastures, they need a good topsoil to thrive and survive well. And what makes a soil a topsoil is that a topsoil has life in it. And the term we use is soil biology. The first part of the community in your soil are all the soil microbes. In a handful of soil, there'll be millions and millions of the soil microbes there. And these guys play a really important role. The parts to the soil microbe community are your bacteria. These are really, really small and obviously you can't see them. The fungi, sometimes you can see these guys breaking down organic matter. And the protozoa, who you can't see, but they're a little bit bigger than the bacteria and fungi. All of these three guys help cycle your nutrients, they break down organic matter, and they help control diseases. The second part to your soil life is the larger soil organisms, and these are the guys that are easy to see with the naked eye. A healthy topsoil should have a diversity of soil organisms in it. The main ones you might see are earthworms, beetles, and some smaller ones like springtails and mites. And plants love to grow in soils where you've got lots of healthy soil organisms in there because they help to create soil structure and they also help with the nutrient cycling in your soil. The last part of the community of life in your soil are the living roots of plants. They're the ones that we sometimes don't think about, but they're actually part of the most important part of your soil's biology. Living roots give off lots of sugars and compounds into the soil, which provides food for all the other living things, those microbes and those soil organisms.
The reason why I put a mixed species in is because the living plants are feeding the organisms in the ground, so they need diversity too. So the more diversity, the better for all the microorganisms. You just feed them one thing all the time, like sugarcane roots or even a legume crop. It's just one food source, so we need lots of diversity. If you build a home, they'll come.
Beautiful.
The soil microbes, the ones we can't see, the soil organisms that we can see, and the living plant roots, together they make up your soil's community. And basically, you need a really healthy, diverse community to provide your soil with some real key benefits. The first key benefit is it stores and cycles your nutrients effectively. You get really efficient use of fertilizers, and nutrients like nitrogen and sulfur can be held in the soil and made available to plants. The second benefit is it helps to create soil structure. You can't buy soil structure in a bottle. Soil structure is created by the interaction between living plant roots, soil microbes, and soil organisms. The third benefit is it helps to minimise those pests and diseases that may also be there. And over 95% of all the guys there are actually helping to keep your soil-borne pests and diseases in control. So soil biology and soil life is really important to your farm business and to your topsoil's health. If you want to learn more, get in touch with your extension officer, terrain, or follow the links to learn how you can improve the soil life in your topsoil.